Foreigners buying up Australian farms have triggered a new flashpoint in federal politics. Political editor Hugh Rimmerton has more on this story tonight. Hugh, the federal opposition has changed tack on this one, but what do they want now?
Well, Sandra, they certainly want more scrutiny. They want the level of foreign investment to be lowered at the point at which it starts to get some examination from the organisation known as the Foreign Investment Review Board. But there are divisions within the coalition on this, and the government says it could jeopardise key trade deals with China.
An uneasiness is creeping across the country.
I think the concern is really just the unknowns with it.
Here near Yass, Chinese buyers recently snapped up Bobra Station for a rumoured $20 million.
I think what farmers would like is a bit more transparency.
That mood is now shifting opposition thinking.
There needs to be a sufficient level of scrutiny.
Nearly 90% of our farms are Australian-owned. The proportion that is foreign-controlled is tiny but growing. The coalition, spurred by the Nats, now want closer examination of foreign investment in farming assets.
We've always supported foreign investment. We continue to support foreign investment.
But only now under the right conditions.
And the right conditions are when it is unambiguously in Australia's national interest.
It is certain that this would terminate negotiations for free trade agreements with China, Japan and South Korea.
It's a dog's breakfast. I mean, they are all over the shop.
Former Howard Government Minister Peter Reith is one of those outraged. Coalition plans for the Foreign Investment Review Board should be dumped, he tweeted, calling it pandering to populism. John Howard himself was in China last week talking up Australia's foreign investment opportunities.
And let me say, without any kind of conditionality, that foreign investment should be welcomed from all parts of the world.
But in National Party country, it could be a winner.
There's no doubt there are fears about foreign investment in some parts of the country. Are there facts to justify those fears? The opposition says it's really just trying to find out. Others, though, sniff a little bit of xenophobia, a little bit of rural populism in the air.
Hugh Rimmerton, thank you.